good day.
So, like, take off to the great white north. Take off. It's a beauty way to go. Take off, you hosers.
All right, welcome to Peyton Suds Report. And that was Bob and Doug McKenzie. For those of you who are around my age, we just got back from up north there. Hey, Peyton.
Yeah, really.
What do you think about the Brewers this week?
They had a great, they had such a great week, really. Everything's clicking, and this is a team that I envisioned before the season that we could be in. Everyone's healthy, and
they're hitting on all cylinders.
Yeah.
Let's start out. We were up north, up by Eagle River, for a week, but on Monday, June 21st, the Diamondbacks had 5, Brewers 1. Brewers had 5 total hits. You have down about Brett Anderson and Jake Cousins. Go ahead.
Yeah. Brett Anderson, it was a really quick outing for him because he got injured in the second inning. He only pitched 2 innings because he had a leg injury, I think it was. And he's going to be on a 10-day IL. But later in the game, Jay Cousins came into the game, and the Brewers just called him up.
And the Milwaukee Journal had a great article about him coming up later in his 20s through the, is it the Independent League or Northwoods?
No, Independent League.
Independent League, and he thought he was about to quit baseball.
Yeah, that's what it said.
And here he is 2 to 3 years later pitching for the Brewers.
And doing well. He's pitched 4 innings, and he has 9 strikeouts and no home runs.
Just this last week. Yeah. Tuesday, the 22nd of June, Brewers 5, Diamondbacks 0. Yelich and Wong each hit home runs and had 2 hits apiece.
Yeah.
And change up Fred.
Yes. Yeah, Freddy is, well, I mean, the beat goes on for him. He's just
7-2.
He's 7-2. He's just amazing. The Brewers, I don't think we're quite sure what we were going to get out of him starting instead of in the bullpen, but he's been amazing. And then Juan continues to do very well. He's an all-star candidate. In my mind, he should be an all-star.
You can't go wrong with him, can you?
No, not at all. And then Yelich, he hit a home run, which is very encouraging. So hopefully he can keep it up.
And we're going to Wednesday, but before that, Peralta, no earned runs, 10 strikeouts.
Yeah,
amazing.
It's amazing.
Wednesday the 23rd, Brewers 3, Diamondbacks 2. Tyrone Taylor and Peterson each had 2 hits. Not the most popular guys on the club as far as notoriety, but solid players who are always seem to be there. Woodruff had a great outing. 9 Ks, 1 earned run, 7 innings.
Yeah, just like Freddie Peralta. I mean, it's like you almost just expect it out of Woodruff. He's having an insane season.
And Tyrone Taylor, every time he swings, I feel like the stitches are going to come out of the ball.
Yeah, he's leading the team in exit velocity. I think he's averaging like 96 miles an hour.
Yeah.
And like you said, you know, him and Jace Peterson, you know, are the most, like, of the players that get the most notoriety, but that makes a quality team when everyone's pitching in and helping them win games.
It seems like seems like Tyrone Taylor swings angry.
Yeah,
he's aggressive. I love it.
Every time he steps up, he's looking to do damage.
I wouldn't want to break into his house and get bopped on the head with a baseball bat. Thursday, June 24th, they were off. Friday, June 25th, Brewers 5, Rockies 4.
Nice.
They were about to lose. Was it 4-2?
Yes.
Bottom of the ninth, and up steps the savior. I mean, not the savior, but Adames, Willie Adames, 3-for-5, and he did what?
He in the bottom of the ninth, with like you said, the Brewers are down 4-2. He had a 2-run home run. in the bottom of the ninth inning. And it made it extra special because it was the first game with full capacity. They call it reopening day. So it was clearly like a special, memorable moment.
And one of our favorite players over the last 2-3 years, we watched him get drafted. Yes. Was Keston Hira. We felt for him when he went down twice because of lack of production. But he gets the game-winning sack fly in the 11th.
You have to feel just great for him. And, you know, hopefully this can be the start of I'm going to talk about it a little later, but he had another good game today, so hopefully he is, you know, can produce.
Burns had a great outing, 6 innings, 1 earned run, 7 Ks, and there's that Jake Cousins again. Yeah. 2 more innings pitch, 4 Ks and 2 innings.
It seems like Elvis could step on the mound and do great. I mean, it's every pitcher.
What a bullpen. Yeah. What a starting rotation.
Pitching, just pitching.
Finally, the hitters are starting to come around. Yes. It only took them a couple months. Saturday, June 26th, Brewers 10, there we go, Rockies 4. That was our, that was on our way back from the cabin, right?
Yeah, we had just come back.
Wong went 3-for-4, had the injury. Garcia had 3 hits, and including his 14th home run. And Yelich hit another home run.
It was tight going into the bottom of the eighth, and then, like a volcano in Hawaii, it just erupted. You know, Juan got a hit, you know, just everyone was getting hits. It was like the Oprah show. You get a hit, and you get a hit. It was just a huge inning, and...
That's a good analogy, or a good simile there.
Yeah, and... But like you said, Juan had to leave the game, but they said, Clint Counsell said it was just day-to-day, so I think he had a cramp. So
You might have just gotten Keston Hira's new nickname, the Hawaiian Volcano.
Yes.
Yeah, and you didn't even know it. June 27th, that's today, Brewers 5, Rockies nothing. Keston Hira, love it. Too bad it's because Vogelbach went down.
Yeah.
Navarez... And Eric Lauer pitched a phenomenal
game. Heck of
a game. Yeah, we're pleased to see him go 6 innings.
Yeah, and that's big, too, because, you know, you can't have Woodruff, Peralta, and Burns, you know, being greedy and getting all the wins. You need someone like Lauer to produce. And
all the heavy hitters in the bullpen? Are well rested now.
Yes.
And the Cubs are coming to town.
Yeah, Hito didn't pitch today. Williams didn't pitch today. So Boxberger also.
Suter.
Yeah. It's a really great save.
All right, we're going to change. Peyton, I saw you touch your microphone earlier in the show. Do you have like an unknown substance on there that
you're. No.
We're going to briefly talk about.
You can check it if you want.
Yeah. Check your belt loop. And
yeah.
We're going to briefly talk about the MLB cracking down on pitchers. Little bit of a joke with some people, funny, but several players have gotten hit in the head or in the face this year, and they think it's, you know, the pitcher's doctoring the ball.
Yeah.
The first spit ball, we looked it up, was in 1902, and the famous Gaylord Perry was known to doctor the ball well. Yeah. What's your opinion on this whole situation?
Well, I don't know. I mean, like you said, Gaylord Perry was the famous person who did it. But I don't know. It just kind of went quiet for a long time. And I don't know. It's really resurfaced. But you can't have guys getting hit in the face and the head, you know.
Or pitchers pitching a ball and it moving when it's not supposed to be because of the aid of a foreign substance.
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of like what steroids did in a way.
Yeah, totally. And, you know.
Changing the game with an artificial substance.
Yeah, and they say that, you know, pitchers have a big advantage already. So, with the youth, they want to, you know, have more action and more scoring in the game to keep younger audience
interested.
And this dude's ruins all of that. There's not one scoring.
I think it's kicked out of the game in a 10-day suspension, isn't it, or something?
Yeah. Yeah, just today they were saying a pitcher was found using it, and him and the manager got ejected.
Oh, didn't know that. All right, the upcoming schedule, the Cubbies come to town.
Yes.
Cubs at Brewers. Yep, yeah, and we're kind of locked and loaded, right?
Yeah.
Using a Marine Corps terminology, we're locked and loaded, ready to fire. Because we have Freddie Peralta, Brandon Woodruff, and Corbin Burns ready to face the Cubs.
Yeah, that's a dream scenario, especially against the Cubs when you are fighting for a division title.
We're going to see if the Brewers' pitching and bullpen's the real deal.
Yeah, definitely, because, the Cubs are the Brewers' rivals, and I know this is a Brewers show, but you have to give the Cubs credit. They are a good team with a good offense.
Yeah. So they've been winning quite a bit.
This is a good test.
They've been winning quite a bit, right along. Seems like the Brewers were winning, they were winning, we were losing, they were losing. But this past week, we're up on them a little bit. And then over the 4th of July, we have a four-game series against the Pittsburgh Pirates, who are at the bottom of the barrel in the Central.
Yes.
So that's kind of nice.
Yeah, it is.
Hauser, Lauer, Peralta, Woodruff again. We're hoping to take at least three, right?
Yeah, but Pirates, they were just talking about it today with the Brewers sweeping the Rockies. The Brewers have to take advantage of playing these below 500 teams.
All right, now the standings. I know the Cubs play tonight, but the current standings as of the Brewer game being over about an hour or so ago. Go ahead, buddy.
Yeah, good. The Milwaukee Brewers, like you said, are in first place. The Cubs are just 2 games behind. That's what makes this upcoming series so big. The Cincinnati Reds are 6 games back in third place. And this really slumping St. Louis Cardinals are sitting in fourth place, 8 games back. And the Pittsburgh Pirates, not surprising at all, are in last place, 15 games back.
And we're about to go. We're going to have it posted on Facebook and YouTube. We hope everybody out there can share it on their Facebook account. And one last thing, you have a bobblehead up there.
Yeah, this is, if you guys don't know, this is a Giannis bobblehead for the Milwaukee Bucks.
The Greek Freak.
Yeah, I bought it like a month before the pandemic started, my last Bucks game. And this is a huge game, game 3 of the Eastern Conference Finals. The Bucks are looking to take a 2-1 lead. So, Giannis, if you're somewhere out there listening and watching the show, need a big game out of you. You have to show up.
I know he's averaging 29 and a half in the first 2 games. So.
Yeah, monster.
So, all right, everybody, we'll see you next week on the 4th of July.
Yes.
Hey, Getty, we'd like to thank you for coming on. The album and singing on the hit single.
Well, it was my pleasure. Eh? Like, I wish you guys lots of success and everything.
I won't let him do it again.
My fault was
you're such a loser.
There's no way I'll ever do another record with you, Hoser.
Okay, that's fine. I'll do a solo album.
Fine, and you'll be looking for me on another label.
All right, everybody. Take off, eh?
Yeah, really.